Richard Swift was born on March 16, 1977 and died on July 3, 2018. He was an American singer, songwriter, multi-instrumentalist, producer and short filmmaker. He was the founder, owner, and recording engineer of National Freedom, a recording studio located in Oregon, and worked as producer, collaborator, muse and influencer for such acts as The Shins, Damien Jarrado, David Bazan, Foxygen, Jesse Balin, Nathaniel Rateliff, The Minor Birds, Wake Owl, Letitia Sadia of Stereo Lab, Gardens and Villa, Kayukus, and Gusta. Swift was a former member of indie rock band The Shins and The Arcs. Swift was also a part of the Black Keys live band from 2014 until his death, performing as their touring bassist and backing singer. Born in California into a musical Quaker family, Swift started performing and singing in churches at an early age. In his youth, his family moved frequently, spending time in rural locations in Minnesota, Utah, and Oregon. As a teenager, he worked at a farm near International Falls, Minnesota. In 2001, Swift moved to Southern California to pursue his solo recording career. That same year, he recorded Walking Without Effort, an initially unreleased album with drummer and producer Frank Lentz. Swift later recorded The Novelist. He recorded many of his early music on a four-track cassette recorder. From 2002 to 2005, he released four small pressings of properly manufactured seven vinyl singles via Velvet Blue Music. Swift also released The Novelist in 2003 and Walking Without Effort in 2005 and combined the two albums to create the double disc The Richard Swift Collection Volume 1 released by Left Wing Recordings in August 2004. He signed to indie label Secretly Canadian, who then re-released the collection in 2005. In 2007, Secretly Canadian and Polydor issued Swift's proper follow-up album, Dressed Up for the Letdown. Later in the year, Swift met Wilco frontman Jeff Tweedy during a taping of the BBC program Later... with Jules Holland. Tweedy asked Swift to support Wilco on their Sky Blue Sky US tour. During the tour, Tweedy invited Swift to record at their Loft Studios in Chicago. In October 2007, Swift started his fourth album at the Wilco Loft Studios. In April 2008, Secretly Canadian released of a double EP named Richard Swift as Onassis. In August 2008, Swift released an EP entitled Ground Trouble Jaw as a free digital download. In April 2009, Secretly Canadian released The Atlantic Ocean. Co-produced by Mark Ronson, the album featured special guests such as Pat Sansone, Casey Fubert, Sufjan Stevens, Sean Lennon, and Ryan Adams. In 2011, he released another solo EP entitled Walt Wolfman. In addition to the music recorded under his own moniker and producing work, he was also briefly a keyboardist in the band Starflyer 59 2002 and 2003, playing live shows and contributing to their 2003 album Old. He also fronted his own electronic music side project, Instruments of Science and Technology. In a 2007 interview, Swift commented on his techniques as a producer and engineer, stating, "Most of my recording techniques come from looking at photos on the inside of Sly and the Family Stone or Beatles LPs, or from watching Sympathy for the Devil and thinking, oh, that's where they put the mic." Swift is known to often provide hefty contributions as a multi-instrumentalist to the albums he produces. In 2009, he began spending more time working with other artists as producer and band member. May 2010 saw the release of fellow Secretly Canadian recording artist Damien Jarrado's record Saint Bartlett. In 2010, Swift also produced The Minor Birds' What We Lose in the Fire, We Gain in the Flood and co-produced Letitia Sadia's album The Trip. He joined The Shins in 2011 and began touring with the Black Keys as their bassist in 2014. In 2015, He produced the self-titled album for Nathaniel Rateliff and the Night Sweats. Swift lived in Cottage Grove, Oregon, where he met his wife Sheilyn. They have three children. Pitchfork reported on June 19, 2018, that Swift had been hospitalized in Tacoma, Washington, recovering from an undisclosed life-threatening condition, and that a GoFundMe had been set up to help cover his medical expenses. He died at 41 years old.